you'll be writing a story about that. Okay, so right now, so what are these two tasks that you have to keep in mind? So please look at the circular which is in the group, those who have joined me late. So please listen once again. So we are going to do a lot of reading. We have a reading challenge for us, which CBSE has given us. And we're going to live up to the challenge. We are going to read, isn't it? We can read, but we're going to read a little more. And yes, so what are you going to do? You're going to read Tom Sawyer, right? So read the last chapters, 7-8 chapters, read from chapter 16 onwards. And if you're good enough, you can read the whole book again. No problem if you are able to do it. And on Saturday, I am going to have a discussion. So of those chapters that you have read, you're going to talk about that. And of course, I will be noting down your responses. Next week, what are we going to do? We'll be writing a story. I'll be discussing it with you all, how that we're going to write this story. And then on Saturday, you'll be reading out your stories. Okay, let's see what story you have written. Fine. So I'll be giving you hints. I'll be giving you characters. I'll be giving you, maybe an outline that this is how you're going to start the story. This is how you're going to end the story. Okay. And then you'll be writing your own short story. And then we're going to read out. And yes, we're all going to appreciate everybody's work. I want maximum participation. Maximum means each one of you are going to participate. So there's not going to be any excuse at all. Simple, simple stories we're going to do. I might ask you to read. Yes, from this Saturday, we're going to start. Manisha will start from this Saturday. So I might ask you to read, maybe a Panchtantra tale. I might ask you to read an article from the newspaper. I might ask you to, write about a recipe, which your grandmother likes or favorite thing that your grandmother makes. Tell her to, tell you the recipe and you can just write it down and read out to us. Okay. Right. So just reading here. So reading, it does not have to be these big thick books that you're going to read. Reading can be a short story that you have read. Okay. Let's read more. And let's see here what all other things that we are supposed to do. Yes, we're going to start this Saturday and expect you all, because Tom Sawyer was already given to you as homework, wasn't it? So we're going to start with that. Now, we're going to start with the next chapter for this term. And you all must remember that this is term two going on, right? Oh, you've read Canterville Ghost also. Very good. That's nice. And Canterville Ghost is also very interesting. Ah, Prableen. Of course, Prableen. I expect you to read more, right? Yes, that's very good. And what are we going to do? What was I just saying? Yes. So all these chapters plus the other chapters also, which you had up till your December test, they are included in your term two, right? So, of course, I'll be telling you the syllabus again and again. Once again, please wake up your friends, tell them to join the class, and you're having classes every day. And we'll be teaching from home, okay, till further instructions. And let's hope things get better soon. Okay, can you see the screen? All of you, can you see the screen? Yes. So we are going to start with the chapter, A Short Monsoon Diary. We have done diary writing. Yes or no? What is a diary? What's a diary entry? What's a diary writing? What is it? What do you think it is? Yes? Yes, Harbhajot? Want to give the answer? Please turn on your video and give me the answer. Oh, Vedanti, very good. We talk to a diary. Yes, we talk to a diary. Yes, Argunjot, please, you can unmute yourself. Tell me, what's a diary?
Ma'am, in which we write about our things that we have done or incidents.
Yes, right. Very good. Very good. Very nice. So we write about incidents. We write about things that we have done. We write about our wonderful experiences. We write about our happy experiences. We can write about our sad experiences. You can write a diary every day also, isn't it? And yes, so it is. Sometimes you might not write your diary for weeks and weeks also. And yes. So generally, we do write in the diary here. And yes, what's a journal? What's a journal? How is a journal different from a diary? Diary, that is, yeah, people, they you have to, they do it every day after day. So journal, it might not be so regular. Okay, you also have right, you have your log books also, where right, you have an account of every hour that you did. Supposing you went sightseeing somewhere, you went on a holiday somewhere, you want to describe about what. So 10 a.m. I left my room, went for a walk. So 12, a quick brunch, you know, 2 o'clock, right? Again, a walk in the hills, right? Something like that. So you have that here. But diary, yes, you share your experience, you write about experience, your good experience, your bad experience, your happy experience. And yes, most of the times, do we share what we have written in our diaries? Do we share? Generally, we don't. But there are some diaries that have become very, very famous, and they have been read by so many people all over the world. One of those diaries is the Diary of a Young Girl by Anne Frank, right? Have you heard about, so this Diary of Anne Frank? Yes, it is the Diary of a Young Girl, or the Story of a Young Girl. It is by Anne Frank. And who was Anne Frank? She's a very famous person now. So she was this young girl, yes, a Jew, a survivor, and not a survivor, but just she passed away in the concentration camps. But what survived was her diary. So she had to escape with her parents. So they went into hiding. And for the months that she was there, she wrote the diary about the things that she did. And later on, when the war was over, when her father came back, he went to their hiding place and he saw the pages of her diary scattered. What did he do? He collected those pages and he got this book published, and it became one of the most popular books, right? So we have the Diary of a Young Girl, or by Anne Frank. Okay, now here, yes, do you ever write a diary? Do you write a diary? Generally, we start new year, new diary, and we think, okay, I'm going to write something. And so do you ever feel like writing something? Yes, a beautiful experience that you had, anything that, do you feel like writing it down? Have you ever tried writing it? Yes, what other things would you, you want to become a journalist? That's very nice, Vedanti, very nice. So, right? So you can start from now only. So you should start writing your diary. So what is it? What are the things would you like to write about? If you had to write a diary, what is it that you would write to? Your classroom experience, is it? Something special that happened? Yes, right? You're going to write about your friends? Are you? Right? Or something like that you can write about? Yeah. So you have about your expressions, you can talk about, things that you like about the classroom, or maybe something that you did, you helped your mother, she was so happy, and it was a special moment for you, isn't it? So many things that we write in our diary. Maybe, yes, you planted a sapling and you saw it right in front of your eyes over the periods of weeks and months, how it's grown, right? Or anything it is there, any experience here. So it is not necessary, you know, like we have to talk about all these things here. So we are going to read about a short monsoon diary. Yes, heartwarming moments, beautiful moments, happy moments, all these moments are there. And yes, what is it? What about monsoon diary? What do you think is there about the monsoon which might give you happiness? Yes, it's raining nowadays, right? So it's been there for the past 2-3 days. And what about the rainy season? If you had to write something about the rain, how does the rain affect you in the winter? How does it affect you in the summer? How does it affect you? Right? So in the winters, do you actually go outside and see how the things have changed because of the rain? Do you? You want to stay inside and you feel rain go away? Is it? Yes? And so many things are there, right? Okay, you see, feel that it's so wet and it's become even more cold. And do you feel happy or do you feel depressed or what do you feel? Think, okay, thank God nature is, giving us rain and the earth is getting water. We might, we should conserve this and all things like that coming to your mind. Yes. Right. In summer, it is a big relief. Absolutely. So when the rain comes in the summers, it's a big relief. And if you had to write your diary entry would be happy, happy, happy. Isn't it? Oh, my God. I got wet in the rain. You feel happy getting wet in the rain? If I ask you now, go out and, there's something outside, right? And bring it in. Will you go? No, it's too cold. Look at the wind and rut. So our feelings are going to be different when we write the diary in the winters, in the rainy seasons. Oh my God, the weather is so dull and bleak. My mood is also feeling like that. Let me make a cup of coffee. But now diary, I have to go because mummy has made dinner. That's a favorite thing to do, isn't it? That's how we end our diary. Yes. Yeah. So right, not in winters. No way, right? So in summers, we feel happy. But in winters, we feel what? Not sad. We feel, right, I can't go outside. Where's the sun? We want the sun in the winters also, right? Yes, but winter should be like this. No, it should be chilly. We need the chill also to feel winters, right? Now, in the hills, if we had to write about a diary about the monsoon in the hills, right? Do you think it feel the monsoon we're talking about, right? So we're not talking about the winter rains here. So what would it feel like in the hills? Yes. What would the rain feel like in the hills, right? In the winters, we feel lazy. We feel cold because we're cold. But in the summer, we're very excited. We're energetic when it rains. We feel very happy. So what about the hills here when it rains in the hills? How does it feel? Right? So we're going to read about that. Yes, all of you, look at the screen. And who has written this short monsoon diary? It is Ruskin Bond. Have you read stories by Ruskin Bond before? Yes, we have read stories by Ruskin Bond. Okay, we're going to read a few more stories about Ruskin Bond by Ruskin Bond in our reading challenge. Okay. Now here, look at his diary. And Jenny, what is the format of a diary entry? What's the format of a diary entry? You have your day, date, and time, right? So, right, so here it is quite flexible here. So what has he written? June 24. So monsoon, we're talking about the summer months when the monsoon comes or the rainy season here. So, right, so it is generally right from the end, or you can see the end of June, the first week of July, when the rainy season sets in. The first day of monsoon mist. And it's strange how all the birds fall silent as the mist comes climbing up the hill. Beautiful. First day of monsoon mist. What's mist? What do you think is mist? Yes? Mist kya hota hai, fog types, right? So it's not very clear. And right, so it is there in the rainy season, in the hill also, right? The hilly areas, what is there that mist has come? How all the birds fall silent as the mist comes climbing up the hill, as if the mist is a person, as if the mist has been personified. Perhaps that's what makes the mist so melancholy. Melancholy means sad. Just like nowadays, it's been raining. And what has happened to our mood? We're also feeling a little sad. We're feeling a little melancholy, right? Not only does it conceal the hills. Conceal means cover, hides the hills. Because in the mist, you can't see far. You can't see what is there right across. And the mist comes and covers everything. It blankets them in silence too. Blanket, right? It's covered the hills with a blanket. It's made them silence. And that is why the mist is not very welcome over there. It seems the birds have become quiet. The hills have become quiet. Only an hour ago, the trees were ringing with bird song. How were the trees ringing with bird song? Means what? The birds were singing and the, right? Water on grass is not mist. Those are dew drops. Okay? You see that water, the droplets, those are dew. Okay? So mist, right? Yes. So you have the kind of a little fog coming up. That is there. Okay? Right? So what is bird song? The birds singing. What has the mist done? What has the mist done? It has made the birds silent. And that is why people don't like the mist coming here, because everything becomes quiet. And when you go to the hills, there are so many trees around you. What do you expect to hear? A lot of chirping, a lot of sound. But the mist comes and makes everything quiet. And now the forest is deathly still, as though it were midnight. The forest is very quiet. And you're walking there. Imagine you're walking on that road and there's mist all around you. And the forest is so quiet. You can't hear the birds. You can't hear other animals. Would you feel very brave or would you feel a little scared? It would be a little scary. Yes. Okay. Though through the mist, Biju is calling to his sister. You can't hear the birds singing, but you can hear people, right? So Biju is there calling to his sister. I can hear him running on the hillside, but I cannot see him. Why he can't see him? Why he can't see him? Yes? Why he can't see him? Because? Oh, yes, it's because the mist is there. And what is the mist doing? What is the mist doing? What has the mist done? Mist has covered everything. Right? So they can hear the sound, but they can't see. So what is it that the narrator or the writer, what can he hear? He can hear Biju calling, but he can't see him. Why he can't see him? Because there is mist. Yes, because the mist has covered. There is no visibility. There's nothing to be seen, but the sound can be heard. So June 24. So see here, right? What has he written about? Has he written about the whole day? Or has he written just one particular experience of the day? So when you write a diary entry, it is not necessarily you have to write about each and everything that you did. It has to be, or it is about a special thing that happened that day, right? Some moment that really touched you, a moment that you would like to talk about. So what is he talking about? Yes, he's talking about the mist. What did the mist do? Yes. Yeah, Biju is the name of a person. Biju, his friend, right, is a person. He's calling to his sister. That means someone calling his sister. So Biju is there calling his sister. Okay. Ye samajh mein aa gaya? Kya hai? The first day of monsoon mist. So it's a special moment. Right? So we talk about when there is too much of rain, we will talk about that. And because of the rain, what happened? This mist came. And yes, so what all happened because of the arrival of the mist? So he's talking about one day, the first day when the mist happened. So next day when the mist is going to happen, again, the same things might happen, right? So things are not seen. The birds, they become quiet. Nothing is seen. And you can hear people calling, you can hear the animals, but what has become silent? The bird's song, the trees have become silent, okay? So, right, so it is not necessarily that in the diary, you are going to write about each and everything. You're going to talk about an important moment, okay? Next, June 25. Some genuine early monsoon rain. Warm and humid and not that cold high altitude stuff we've been having all year. The plants seem to know it too. And the first cobra lily rears its head from the ferns as I walk up to the bank and post office. So right, so there's some early monsoon rain. And yes, so this rain, in the monsoon, we don't feel cold when we get wet. unless and until it's a very heavy shower and we are in the rain for a long time. So we welcome that rain. We're very happy in that rain because, yes, it's all green around us. It seems as if new life is coming. But in winters, what happens? Already the trees have shed their leaves. Everything already looks very dull and lifeless. And the rain makes everything even more what? Dull, isn't it? Right? In the winter rain. Now he's talking about the monsoon rain. So kya hai monsoon mein? Plants also coming. So he's saying it is not that cold, high altitude stuff we've been having all year. This rain is not like that. It's not cold, but it is warm. And that warmth of the rain, what does it bring? The plants seem to know it too. First, cobra lily. So you've seen the lily plant, right? It's a white flower. So that cobra lily, here it is. Look at this picture. Rears its head from the ferns. Ferns are evergreen plants. Lots of ferns we see on the hillside, on the mountains. You see lots of it. As I walk up to the bank and post office. So as he's walking in the rain, otherwise in the winters, no, we'll never step out. But in the monsoon, yeah, we'll go for a walk. Never mind. And he can see the plants coming, new plants coming out. He's seen this lily coming out and the ferns over there. And where is he walking? He's walking to the post office in the bank. The mist affords a certain privacy. How does it give a privacy, the mist? What does the mist do? Yes, it covers everything, it hides everything, it blankets everything, isn't it? Right? A schoolboy asked me to describe the hill station and valley in one sentence. And all I could say, a paradise that might have been. Look at this paragraph once again. A schoolboy asked me to describe the hill station and valley in one sentence. And all I could say was a paradise that might have been. So there's a lot of beauty. It's a beautiful place. What is paradise? Like you talk about heaven. Very beautiful place. It could have been paradise. But yes, because there are humans, there are so many things here. It's not always beautiful. There are moments that are not very nice. And right, so nature is not always very kind over here in the hills. So that is why it is a paradise that might have been. Ki achha ho sakta tha aur bhi. But because of nature, because of man, this place, it is not as beautiful as it should have been. Clear? So two diary entries we have done. What does the writer talk about in the first diary entry? What does he talk about? Yes. How mist affords privacy, it covers you. Nobody can see you. You can't see them. So hum kya hai? Apne personal space mein ghum rahe. You can't see that others. Okay. So privacy, that is it. Right? It's like a kind of a curtain. Mist, kya karte hai? Curtain so jata hai, right? You can't see what is there in front of you. It hides the trees, it hides the buildings, it hides people. You can hear them, but you can't see them. So privacy, okay? So in the first diary entry, what does he talk about? What does he talk about? He talks about mist, the first mist they had. Then in the second diary entry, because of the rains, what has happened? There is what? New life. The flowers coming out. There's this cobra lily coming out and the ferns also. So everything is looking so nice. So new plants coming and there's greenery, which is already there. It's becoming even more greener, right? More prettier. So in both of them, he's talking about the mist. And in which season has he written his diary? Which season has he written his diary? Yes. In the monsoon. Yes. So very nice. Very good. Okay. Right. So any doubts over here? So I'm not going to rush things here because we'll be continuing with this tomorrow. Tell your friends also to please join the class. And yes, here. So how is the mist giving the privacy? Or right? Who is Biju? Who is Biju calling out to? Who is Biju calling out to? Yes, he's calling his sister. And could he be seen? Could he see him? Could the writer see him? No. Why he couldn't see him? Because of the mist. Right. And what else becomes silence when the mist arrives? What happens to the trees? What happens to the trees? The birds on the trees, they become quiet, right? So the bird song, it becomes silent. Yes, so they stop singing. The birds, they stop singing. Everything, it seems, it has become very, very quiet. What are the sounds you hear during the rainy season? It keeps on raining and raining and raining. And what are the sounds that you hear? What kind of animals and insects? Yes? What kind of animals and insects? The raindrops, you hear it's the grasshopper, the cricket sound. Yes. You hear the frogs or not? Yes or no? Yes. And the little insects, they come to the light also when you hear the sound also. So with all the seasons here, there is that change, right? So nature shows a different face in all the seasons. Okay. So you're going to read these two diary entries once again. You can read the next one also, June 27, if you want to. And we're going to discuss it tomorrow. And what is your reading task for the week? You're going to read Tom Sawyer. We'll be having a discussion on Saturday. You will be speaking. I'll be listening. Okay. And one of you might be the moderator. You can ask and start of this discussion. Okay. Right. So be prepared. So see you all tomorrow. Take care. Be good. Stay home and stay safe. Okay? Right. So see you all tomorrow.